OMG.
Nice.
Hi, buddy. Huh?
Oh my god!
One.
Oh, let's go.
Of you.
Not entirely. Behind us.
Fucking way, you aimbot. Fuck.
No way, you aimbot. Fuck. Yo, what's going on YouTube? Hope you guys are having a great day so far. Today's video is going to be a pretty long one, I suppose. It might not be. We'll see how it is. But anyways, I'm going to be going over and showing you guys what I do on a daily basis to keep my aim where it's at, how to improve it, how I work on it, and so on and so forth. I'm going to be going through a lot of stuff in this. I'm going through my configurations, my mouse settings, my mouse I use, what Aimlabs scenarios I use, what I do for in-game practice as well, just everything. I'll be showing you guys what you should be working on, what's the most important aspects to know when it comes to aim in Warzone and just Call of Duty as a whole. And currently right now I'm actually working on a personal Aimlabs playlist. I'm going to be throwing a whole bunch of scenarios that I think are really, really good for keyboard and mouse players to practice for Warzone and everything, so you can kind of get that muscle memory down and so on and so forth. But if you guys do enjoy today's video and you actually learned something from it, make sure you drop a like and let me know in the comments down below how your progression with your aim goes. Let me know if you know this actually is helpful and it's actually, you know, turned out to be good for you guys. And also let me know what you guys would like to see more from the channel. And if you are new and you haven't yet, you can hit that subscribe button as well. But yeah, without further ado, we're going to jump into the video. Now, the first thing I want to mention to you guys on keyboard and mouse is don't rely on aim trainers. You know, a lot of people only practice on Aimlabs when it comes to aim, and they jump into Warzone and their aim's all over the place. It's super shaky. Their tracking's very, like, jittery almost. It's not, like, butter smooth. When they're target switching, it's not, you know, snappy, fast. It's slow, off target, and just not, you know, accurate as well. Don't rely on aim trainers. Aim trainers are kind of there just to keep your muscle memory kind of, you know, up. You know, I use aim trainers here and there. I would say I do most of my practice in game now. I'll probably use an aim trainer maybe once a week, if that. But I'm going to show you guys the playlist I use on Aimlabs. It's through my team. It's the Strafes in Warzone playlist, RA. You can go Google it or Google it. You can search it up on Aimlabs itself. Great playlist. It's very tracking oriented. You have long range track. You have gliding, the glide easy scenario where it's pretty much your tracking something falling out of the sky. That's great for Warzone when someone's flying in or whatnot. A lot of close range tracking with like a target moving from side to side. So you're pretty much going to have to keep on the target. And there's reactive target switching, reactive tracking. There's a whole bunch of scenarios in there. I recommend you kind of go through that and see where your weaknesses are. That's what I did. You know, when I first started out Warzone, I noticed that my target switching was great, just because I used to play Call of Duty Modern Warfare all the time, so my target switching was pretty solid. When it came, though, to the tracking, I never had the training in-game to do it, just because the TTK and MW, as you guys know, if you played MW, is, like, so ridiculously quick. It's, like, 100-some milliseconds. It's stupid. So when it came down to, you know, learning tracking for Warzone, you know, I did Aimlabs for a little bit, and I definitely saw an improvement. Ooh. There. The target switching really never, I mean, it got a little more snappier, got a little more accurate, but that, I mean, wasn't as a big of a switch, or a big of a change, I should say, when I worked on tracking versus that. And now, when I do go and play Aimlabs, I usually am only aim training for like about a half an hour to maybe an hour maximum. I don't think I've ever aim trained on Aimlabs for more than an hour. I'm not going for high scores. I'm just making sure that my tracking looks and feels as smooth as possible. I'm making sure that my target switching is, you know, on point. You know, I'm not over flicking or under, like, flicking anything, and just so on and so forth. You know, you don't have to be, you know, if you get insane at an aim trainer, that's awesome, but like, it's not gonna really show up in Warzone per se, because they're two different things, right? You know, it's gonna test two different things. I'll show you all the stuff I do in game so you guys can practice. Aim trainers are great for learning muscle memory and, you know, learning like when there's a situation where you have to track someone out of the sky or track someone out of a car. You know, a lot of those scenarios on Aimlabs will, you know, kind of show in Warzone when you're playing. You're like, oh, you know, like, you know, this is the, you know, when I'm tracking someone out the sky, it's basically like I'm tracking, you know, the ball out in the glider easy scenario. It's somewhat similar, not entirely similar, but you kind of get the gist of it. And by the way, I will link the playlist I use in the description below on Aimlabs. You just go on there, you look up the playlist, you download it, and then you're good to go. Now, when it comes to the in-game practice, I usually just do Modern Warfare private match. I really don't do Vanguard. You know, Warzone is still off of MW's engine and its mechanics. Vanguard, I pretty much forget about. But when it comes to warming up, I usually always go into free-for-all either on Shipment or the map called Atrium. And I usually have 8 bots. I mean, it's up to you. I usually do like 6 to 8 bots. And I always put the health minimum to 200. That way you have a higher TTK, not like a super quick crazy one. So it makes you kind of train to be on target all the time. Like in Warzone, you know, if someone's fully played it up, you know, it's not going to be a TTK of 200 milliseconds. No, it's going to be a higher TTK just because they have a lot more health. It's going to require you to, you know, stay on target a lot. Now, one thing I do as well is for target switching practice, I'll go into the map called Atrium and I'll stand in a corner and kind of center my shot on like the center pillar or one of the center pillars. And I'll kind of just flick, you know, to targets, like if they peek out. So like if one comes to the right, I'll flick to the right and then go right back to the pole and like center my shot again. You know, it kind of works on like the target switching, finding out like that also can help with fine tuning your sense, your DPI, all that stuff. But that's one of the things I do. Now, also too, when I'm in private match, I'll work on my movement. And you know, if I really want to work on close range tracking more, I'll put the bots to a mixed difficulty. So some are sprinting, some are not, some are jumping, some are sliding. That way, and like the health's up to 300. So that way you can really try and like stay up on your target close enough up to 300 health and, you know, get used to that movement to where like in Warzone, if someone slides by you like really quickly, you can learn how to, you know, keep up with that player and keep your crosshair on them. Now, when it comes to in-game tracking practice, this is when I actually go into plunder. I don't really do like rebirth or like normal Warzone to practice this because the scenario, like the amount of times it happens, like the amount of times you can actually practice your tracking in like the normal modes is like bare minimum compared to plunder. But for plunder, I used to, when Verdance was out, I would usually drop into Storage Town or like the hot spot of the map and kind of just practice tracking out of the sky. And Storage Town was just that one area. The one spot that I've noticed, or the two spots actually that you can practice your tracking in Caldera is one, the airfield tents near that area. That's a kind of a hot spot. And the second hot spot, which I found to be more useful for tracking practicing, is Peak. And all you literally gotta do, usually M13, like kind of just stick to your weapon. You know, you don't have to use the same weapon, obviously, but if you wanna like get good with the M13 or the RAM or whatnot, you know, pretty much just dive bomb in and kind of just practice your tracking as they're flying in, right? Another thing you could do though too is not even shoot. You can literally just kind of like try to keep your reticle on the person flying in and try to track them out the sky, and just see, you know where you're struggling. A lot of people struggle with tracking, at least. A lot of people don't struggle with, you know, crosshair placement, like getting near the body. It's more of like the jittery, you know, tracking where it doesn't look fluid, it doesn't look smooth. Like I'll show examples real quick on the screen of like fluid, you know, tracking that looks like super clean, like super, you know, locked in basically, compared to like some jittery tracking I used to have before I started working on my tracking in Aimlabs and in-game. But like I said, the most benefit you will have from tracking or trying to improve your tracking would be in Aimlabs. That's just how I was able to improve it. But it's also really good to try to get that in-game practice as much as you can. So that way when you come, you know, when you're playing normal Warzone, Rebirth Island, etc., when it comes to those scenarios, you're able to, you know, pretty much use muscle memory and be able to do the same exact thing. In the last section of this video, I'm just gonna kind of go over my specs and like what I use, the equipment I use, and also my settings. My in-game sense is 8.75. I'm playing on 400 DPI. I think my Mouse Excel for low zoom multiplier is 1.05. I'll put all this stuff in the description down below for you guys. My current mouse pad that I've been using for a while now is the SkyPAD 2.0 XL, which I am sponsored by. If you want a SkyPAD, you can go to their website, which is also linked down below, and make sure you use code NUMB at the checkout for 10% off. Did you see that advertisement placement? So fucking good. The mouse I currently use is a Glorious D modelless mouse right here. They just recently came out with this. I love the Model D. And I would definitely want to be, I knew they were going to come out with the wireless version, so I definitely snagged it because it's just a great mouse. I also, too, have an Aqua Control Plus mouse pad. I haven't used it in a while, but it's a great pad as well if you don't want to go for the SkyPad. The SkyPad's a little more pricey in it, but if you're looking for a new mouse pad, Aqua Control Plus, I'll also link it down below. An awesome, awesome mouse pad that I definitely saw tracking improvements as well. I also want to mention, too, that I do wear an arm sleeve when I play just because of the glass mouse pad. Sometimes my skin can get a little stuck to it, so I have a SkyPad sleeve as well. Again, you can get one yourself and make sure you use code NUMB at the checkout. I'm so fucking good with these advertisements, man. And a lot of people out there, like I know Strafe is like a mouse connoisseur. I'm not a guy that will go buy like final mouses or, you know, crazy amounts of mice or crazy amounts of like mouse pads or whatever. You know, I stick to what I know and I stick to what I'm good at. And from what I've experienced so far is only great stuff. Like everything that I have and everything I use has only improved my aim. I've gotten used to it, and it's true. You know, the better the mouse pad, the better the aim. I have to say it. You know, you're not going to get ridiculous aim off of like a office brand mouse pad. You know, getting the SkyPAD was definitely a step up, definitely a bit pricey. I mean, this thing is solid glass. It takes up a lot of room, but the thing is awesome. I love it. I definitely have no regards to it. It's definitely improved my aim tenfold. So it is important to, you know, if you really are trying to get better aim in Warzone, you know, try to spend a little bit on, you know, peripherals that will actually, you know, help maintain themselves and, you know, you can improve off of for the future. And if you did make it to the end of the video, I really do appreciate you guys watching till the end. This video took a little bit longer to edit and everything to make it as organized as possible for you guys. So please drop a like and comment down below. And if you are new, consider hitting that subscribe button. Like I mentioned earlier, I'm currently making an Aimlabs playlist for the people in my Discord to use. We will be doing like ranked systems. So the top 10 people or the top 10 scores on the whole playlist will be given a certain role in the Discord channel. If you guys want to join up on the Discord, link is down below. I highly recommend it. That's where you can get all of the information and notifications for uploads, Twitch streams, and so on and so forth. And plus, we have a whole bunch of really cool people that you can vibe out with and even play with if you wanted to as well. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll see y'all in the next one.